देखो, बिकॉज माउंट एवरेस्ट इज एट द कंट्रोवर्सी इन इंडो नेपाल रिलेशंस बिकॉज ऑफ द चाइनीज एटीट्यूड एंड द नेपालीज एटीट्यूड. सो सम ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स हैड आस्क्ड मी टू मेक दिस वीडियो इन इंग्लिश, सो आई एम मेकिंग ए वेरी कंसोलिडेटेड वीडियो इन इंग्लिश ऑल्सो. फ्यू डेज बैक चाइना हैड सेड इन अ स्टेटमेंट दैट माउंट एवरेस्ट इज पार्ट ऑफ तिब्बत, मीनिंग तिब्बत इज पार्ट ऑफ चाइना, so automatically Mount Everest is also part of China. Strangely, there was no protest from the government of Nepal, as also no protest from the Nepalese media. Later, Chinese released a stamp of Mount Everest. Still, Nepal government, Nepalese media and Nepalese people ignored it. Chinese President Xi Jinping had visited Nepal on October 10, 2019 on a two-day visit. He was the first Chinese president to visit Nepal in two decades. During his visit, 20 agreements were signed between Nepal and China, and specially an agreement was signed between Nepalese Prime Minister KP Oli and Chinese President Xi Jinping to jointly measure the height of Mount Everest. Besides, China had also signed an agreement to give an aid of $56 billion to Nepal. Chinese policy during the past few years has been to give loans to small nations, and when they are unable to repay the loan, then Chinese grab their land. China did this Venezuela, which was rich in petrol, but today Venezuela is bankrupt. China gave a loan of $1.6 billion to Sri Lanka for the development of Hambantota port. When Sri Lanka was unable to repay, China took Hambantota port on 99-year lease. China gave $66 billion to Pakistan for CPEC. Due to this, Pakistan has become bankrupt and is unable to repay back. Finally, Pakistan gave their Gwadar port to China on 99-year lease. The Chinese who have been giving loan to Pakistan, they are giving it at an interest of 5-7%, whereas Pakistan has obtained loans from Saudi and UAE at the rate of 3%, and IMF gives them loan even at cheaper cost. Then China tried this with Bangladesh, Maldives and Seychelles, but they escaped Chinese clutches with India's help. On April 3, 2020, 8 Chinese mountaineers belonging to the Chinese PLA visited Nepal to climb Mount Everest with heavy equipment. But they did not inform the Nepalese government about it. They also did not take with them any Nepalese as promised. These mountaineers stayed at the Mount Everest for about 2 hours and 30 minutes and installed some equipment. It is said that the Chinese established 3 5G stations at Mount Everest. They also took some pictures and did mapping of Mount Everest. Chinese mountaineers also installed some surveillance equipment at Mount Everest through which China can keep a secret eye on India, Tibet and Myanmar. When these Chinese PLA personnel went to Nepal in the first week of April 2020, there was complete lockdown in Nepal due to coronavirus. I am sure all flights to and from Nepal were also not operating. Then, how these Chinese PLA mountaineers entered Nepal? First thing is by air, by special plane. In that case, they would have been noticed at Nepal's Tribhuvan Airport. Second choice was by special helicopters. Or third is by road. My guess is that these PLA mountaineers, along with their equipment, went to Nepal by special helicopter. Because by helicopter, from Tibet, they could come directly to the base camp of Mount Everest in Nepal with heavy equipment, unwatched and unobserved. Because if they had travelled by road, a lot of people could have known about it, about the movement of this vehicle and the equipment. Due to coronavirus and lockdown, the tourists in Nepal are not allowed to go to Mount Everest. But then how these 8 Chinese PLA mountaineers were allowed to go to Mount Everest unnoticed? Must be with the full knowledge and approval of Nepalese government, and KP Oli must have known about Chinese mountaineers and their plan. So it leaves no doubt that these 8 Chinese mountaineers had gone to Mount Everest with full knowledge of Nepal government and full knowledge and approval of Nepalese Prime Minister KP Oli. So it means that special arrangements for these Chinese PLA were made to go to Mount Everest, and that too without any Nepali mountaineering accompanying them. After issuance of my videos, some Nepali parliamentarians have questioned APOLU on this account. Then, since the mission of these Chinese mountaineers was secret, that is to install special equipment to keep an eye on India, it was most suitable time that no one was observing them. Thus, it confirms that there was a conspiracy or secret arrangement between Chinese and KPOLU against India. I understand that after my videos, Indian government is taking up this issue with Nepal at the highest level and seeking clarifications. If Nepali government fails to clarify or satisfy India, India may resort to direct action against Nepal. I must tell you here that this action of the Nepalese government raises the question that is Nepal at war with India? It's a very serious issue, and I am sure this will not go unnoticed or unattended by the Nepalese government. Thank you very much.